everyone. It's good to be with you again today. I hope you are well and excited to see what happens in today's lesson, that is about what happens after Christmas. But first, let's sing a song together.
A newborn king to see, pa.
Last week, our memory verse was from Matthew 2, verse 9 to 10. On their way, they saw the same star that they had seen in the east. When they saw it, how happy they were! What joy was theirs! It went ahead of them until it stopped over the place where the child was. Today, our memory verse is John 1, verse 14. The Word became a human being and full of grace and truth lived among us. We saw His glory, the glory which He received as the Father's only Son. Let's say that again. John 1, verse 14. The Word became a human being and full of grace and truth lived among us. We saw His glory, the glory which He received as the Father's only Son. Let's sing one more song together. This is the second Sunday after Christmas. It has been hardly more than a week since we were celebrating Christmas, opening gifts, and eating a huge Christmas dinner. What is left of the Christmas celebration? A trash bag full of used wrapping paper and empty boxes. The Christmas tree and all the decorations have been taken down and stored like every year. Christmas is over and our lives have returned to normal. But wait, is it really over? Is that all there is to Christmas? Is it just a time for decorations and parties, giving gifts to friends and family, and a time for family to be together? The last few weeks we have seen that there is a lot more to Christmas than just that. But what happens now? Do we have to wait another year before we can experience the wonder of the birth of our Savior? Let's read what the Bible says what happens next. We're reading from John 1, verse 9 to 14. This was the real light, the light that comes into the world and shines on all people. The Word was in the world, and though God made the world through Him, yet the world did not recognize Him. He came to His own country, but His own people did not receive Him. Some, however, did receive Him and believed in Him, so He gave them the right to become God's children. They did not become God's children by natural means, that is, by being born as the children of a human father. God Himself was their Father. The Word became a human being and full of grace and truth lived among us. We saw His glory, the glory which He received as the Father's only Son. Our Bible readings today reveal a true meaning of Christmas. The Bible says that the Word became a human and came to live among us. The Word that the Bible is talking about is Jesus. He came on Christmas Day, full of unfailing love, and we have seen His glory. we have seen the glory of God's only Son. What did you get for Christmas? No doubt you received some toys or clothes, but the most important gift that any of us can receive is that Jesus came to earth as the gift from God. To those who receive him and believe in his name, he gave the right to become God's children. Jesus came to the world, but many did not recognize him. For those who did not know the Savior, Christmas is over. But for those of us who did receive the gift from the Father, Jesus, our Christmas goes all year long. So let us pray. Dear Lord, forgive us for putting you away after Christmas, for not thinking about you and not praying to you. Thank you for being with us throughout the entire year. You are truly the reason for every season, and we love you. Amen. Let's sing one more song together. Thank you for joining me to learn more about the very first Christmas. I hope you can now do the activities that go with this lesson and have a great week. Bye!